Hey guys, welcome to my channel, or welcome back. My name is Lara, for those of you that do not know or may not recognize me because of my new haircut. And today I'm going to be doing an after playlist video. This has been highly requested by you guys, and I said that I really wanted to do it. I was just having trouble trying to figure out how I was going to format it and how I kind of wanted to do it. So basically what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna tell you a list of 20-ish songs that I love that remind me of after. I'll go through all of them and tell you kind of what aspects of it make me think of after. And I'm gonna play you like a little clip from the song. I was planning on doing this in my playlist book tag style, which is where I lip sync to the songs and kind of speed them up, but I really wanted you guys to just kind of get a feel for the song, know why I like it, and that's really it. I don't want to make it some crazy video. Obviously, I have more than 20 songs that remind me of after, but these are just the ones that I chose to share with you in today's video. And if you want me to do a follow-up, you know, part two video, then I will for sure do that for you guys. I'm also not including like super obvious songs like Never Say Never by The Fray or like Never Let Me Go by Florence. Like, it's really just songs that remind me of after, and I'll explain as I go. So I'm just gonna get started and share with you guys the songs. Okay, the first song on my list is Small Doses by Bebe Rexha. Literally, when this song came out like a few years ago, I immediately like correlated it to after because it reminds me of after so much. It reminds me so much of Harden and Tessa's relationship and just the crazy ups and downs that they go through and how they can only take each other in small doses because they always fighting. So yeah, it's a really good song. I love Bebe Rexha. I think I have some other songs by her on this playlist, but it's really a good song and it totally reminds me of Hessa. And now we're crying and loving, and now we're fighting and touching. Feels like I'm making love to the enemy. The next song on my list is Pillow Talk by Zayn Malik. This is a song that I didn't originally like associate with after at all, but upon listening to it like a year or two ago, I was like, wow, like it sounds so much like after, just like, you know, the fighting and the loving, and it's kind of like small doses in that way. It's very like back and forth, which is totally Hessa. Any song that's like that is totally Hessa. So this song specifically is really very realistic to Hessa, I feel like. So we'll piss off the neighbors in the place that feels the tears, the place you lose your fears, yeah, reckless behavior. The next song on my list is a newer release, and that is Without Me by Halsey. I heard this song and immediately I was like, okay, after. Like, it's literally after. I feel like the song is really about somebody that's built somebody up to like their highest potential, and then they do some shit to them and they end up having this big falling out. And it really reminds me of like the fourth book and Harden kind of just blowing Tessa off, you know, in England. So that's kind of where I related the song to, but it's really a good song and it totally gives me Hessa vibes. And if they laugh, then fuck them all. And then I got you off your knees, put you right back on your feet, just so you can take advantage of me. The next song on my list is The Way I Loved You by Taylor Swift. Really, it's just the chorus that reminds me of Harden and Tessa in this song, because the song is about somebody who's moved on from one of their past relationships, but they like really miss like the craziness that was their past relationship, and now they're just dating some like boring person. So I would imagine this is like how Tessa or Harden would feel if they were dating somebody else. Not that they ever do that though, so you know, that's good. But the chorus definitely has like these lines that just totally remind me of Hessa and their relationship, so that's why it's on my list. But I'm in screaming and fighting and kissing in the rain, and it's 2 a.m. and I'm cursing your name. The next song I have is Heaven by Julia Michaels. And now this was a song that was written for 50 Shades of Grey. And I know some people literally hate when after is compared to 50 Shades of Grey, so I'm not gonna do that. But the song has just like this one iconic line that's like, all good boys go to heaven, but bad boys bring heaven to you. And that's very just like, bad boy, Harden. Yeah, so that's why the song makes me think of after. They say all good boys go to heaven, but bad boys bring heaven. It's automatic. The next song is such a throwback. I don't even know if half of you are gonna know what this song is, because it was never even like a popular single or anything, but it's How Do You Love Someone by Ashley Tisdale. Ashley Tisdale had a banging album, Guilty Pleasures. Anybody? Anyone? I don't know. But this song is so Harden and Tessa. The song just opens up and she starts singing about how like her mother never taught her this, or her dad never taught her this, or she never saw love between her parents, so she never knew how to love somebody herself and she doesn't know what to do about it. And it just kind of reminded me of both Harden and Tessa, because they both have, you know, kind of rocky relationships with their families and their parents especially. So I can kind of relate the song to either of them, but it just speaks really true. And I actually mentioned this song in a playlist book tag before about After, and it just like is so spot on and so random. I've always really liked this album from Ashley Tisdale, so when I just randomly re-listened to it one day, I was like, that song is so Hessa. So it's a really good one, kind of random, but I had to throw it in there. Is Clairvoyant by The Story So Far. The Story So Far is literally like my favorite band of all time, and this song is kind of one of their slower ones. They're more known for like pop punky music, which I have another song by them on here, I believe, but this one is kind of slowed down and it really reminds me of Harden. There's this one line in particular that says, "Don't paint me black when I used to be golden," and that really reminds me of Harden, just kind of like him and Tessa and the fighting and like her thinking that he's never done anything good for her when he has, even though he's done bad things. And it's just like a really good heartfelt song, and a lot of it just reminds me of him, so I really like it. It's a great song in general, so yeah.
The word that you left me is alright, it's alright if I argue the point, then we yell and we fight.
Oh, and then two other songs that are also by The Story So Far that remind me of Harden are Quicksand and Rally Cap. Both of these songs have like really like aggressive vocals and just kind of like the words just remind me of Harden. And I don't know if just Harden has a lot of, you know, similarities with Parker Cannon, the lead singer of The Story So Far, but it kind of seems like it. So those two songs totally remind me of Harden. I could probably list more, but those ones stick out to me the most.
Not learning how to live with my own intended consequences. You're busy jumping.
On my list is another crazy throwback, and that is Anywhere But Here by Hilary Duff, my literal queen. This song is just about wanting to be with somebody and not wanting to be anywhere but here with the person that you love, even if you go through crazy stuff together. Totally Hessa-y. I don't know, I just was listening to the song one day and added it to my playlist, and I was like, yeah, like that fits them. So that's the next song.
I'm falling through the door, flying across the floor.
I have two kind of obvious ones that a lot of you guys have pointed out to me. First one being Starving by Zedd and Hailee Steinfeld. This is the one that's like, I didn't know I was starving till I tasted you. It's just kind of like Hessa, like Tessa when she first meets Harden, didn't realize what she was missing out on until she falls in love with him, didn't realize that her current boyfriend she didn't even love that much as she thought she did. It just kind of reminds me of the beginning of the first book.
By the way, you do things to my body.
And then the next song, I actually don't really like this song, but so many of you guys told me this is like your ultimate like Hessa anthem, like number one After playlist song, and that's Never Be the Same by Camila Cabello, I believe is how you say her name. I'm not a huge fan of her music, especially this song, but I thought I would throw it in there for those of you that want to hear it and want to compare it to After, so that song too.
And I could try to run, but it will be useless. You're to blame. Just by hitting you, I know I'll never be the same.
Next up, we have Make Me Cry by Noah Cyrus and Labyrinth, whoever that is. This song totally reminds me of Hessa and just like, you know, her saying like, all you ever do is make me cry. It's just kind of tea, so it totally reminds me of them and their relationship.
I never hated you like I do right now, 'cause all you ever do is make me.
Next song is super fitting for Hessa, and that is Back to You by Selena Gomez. basically her just saying like, yeah, like all this stuff happened, but like I'd still go back to you. That's literally Hessa in a nutshell. So this song is super reminiscent of that. It just kind of fits like literally any part of the book where they break up and get back together, you know? So I just had to throw that one in here.
You could break my heart in two, but when it heals, it beats for you. I know it's forward, but it's true.
I have another song on here called Back to You, but this one is by Bebe Rexha and Louis Tomlinson. Another one that's saying like, it always goes back to you, kind of in a different way than the Selena Gomez one, but they kind of have a similar message. So they're both, you know, need to be in the playlist. Another Bebe Rexha song I just had to throw in there is I'm a Mess, which is one of her newer songs, and it's a bop, honestly, but it's basically saying, like, I'm a mess for your love, like, it ain't new. Very true to, like, Tessa for Harden. Honestly, both of them, Harden to Tessa, too, they're both kind of a mess, so I just thought it was fitting.
Everything's gonna be alright, everything's gonna be okay, it's gonna be a good, good life, that's what my therapist say.
Next song on my playlist is Starring Role by Marina and the Diamonds. This is just kind of a song about feeling like second best to somebody else, and like if you can't be the starring role in somebody's heart, like why be in their heart at all? And I just kind of feel like it relates to like the beginning of Tessa and Harden's relationship and how he wasn't like honest with her, and like she was walking around thinking like he was her boyfriend, but he would deny that and be like, you thought I was your boyfriend, like all this kind of like annoying stuff that she was like, does he even like me? Am I even his girlfriend, like what's going on? So that just really reminds me of like, you know, the first book, and it's a really good song. So
'cause the only time you open up is when we get undressed. You don't love me, big fucking deal.
Another song by Marina and the Diamonds that I added to my playlist is called Lies. So the song basically is just talking about like somebody lying to you, so like pretty fitting to Harden and Tessa, I would say.
I don't wanna admit that we're not gonna fit. No, I'm not the type that you like. Why don't we just pretend?
Next song on my list is Hate You Love You by Olivia O'Brien. And this song doesn't completely fit with After because there's this one line that kind of throws the song off and like isn't After at all. But just kind of a lot of it is just being like, I hate you, I love you. Like, I hate that I love you. Like, you know, the back and forth again, we're seeing that a lot. It's kind of a very constant theme in this video, actually. Just kind of like the hate-love relationship that they have, and it's very fitting to them.
Now all this time is passing by, but I still can't seem to tell you why. It hurts me every time I see you, realize how much I need you.
Next up, we got 13 Beaches by Lana Del Rey. This is a wonderful song, and it took me a few listens to really connect it to After. There's this one line in the song that says, it hurts to love you, but I still love you. It's just the way I feel. And I feel like that's very Tessa and just kind of like her inner struggle with, should I actually be with Harden after all these ups and downs? Every single time they break up, she's like, is it worth it to get back together if he's just gonna hurt me again? It's just kind of like this debate that she has within herself, and she doesn't know what to do. And the song is very reminiscent of that, and I can totally relate it to their relationship.
I'd be lying if I kept hiding the fact that I can't deal.
The last song on my playlist for today is Ghost by Halsey. This is just kind of a song about being with somebody who's unreliable and somebody you don't know if you can trust them or if they're really there for you or what their motives are. And that just kind of reminds me of Harden and Tessa in the first book again, with Harden kind of being unpredictable in his feelings and emotions and the way that he feels towards Tessa all the time. So that song's really great and totally reminds me of them.
You say that you're no good for me, 'cause I'm always tugging at you. And I swear I hate you and you leave, I like it anyway.
So that is going to be it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed watching it. If you found any new songs that you're now gonna go listen to and add to your After playlist, let me know. Or if there's any songs that you already had on your playlist, let me know. Or let me know songs on your playlist that I didn't have on mine. You know, all of the above. But thank you guys so much for watching this video. Make sure to give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed and subscribe to my channel down below. You can also turn on my post notifications to get a notification whenever I post a new video. Make sure to follow me on my Twitter and Instagram accounts because I'm always chatting about After over on those. But other than that, thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!